More organizations than ever have turned to Microsoft 365 as the platform for their mission-critical business content. Companies like Shell and Cummins have turned to us to deliver content to all of their mission-critical processes, including retention and records management. Let's take a look at how that works.
Let's take a look at how Microsoft 365 extends your retention and records management controls directly into the places where users store and collaborate on documents. Here, in the retail team site, I'm looking at the principal document library. I can tag any document, and in the information pane, see which retention labels are there that I might want to apply. A user can interactively determine whether something is subject to, for example, the confidentiality setting or the contract setting. Let's take a look at how these labels get built. Here, we're in the Microsoft 365 Compliance Center. Over the past year, Microsoft has distinguished the roles of security and compliance administrators based on customer feedback. I establish labels, which encapsulate all the rules for how I retain and manage records, inside of the classification section. We can see labels which are applied for content sensitivity, which allow us to enforce standards like encryption or data loss prevention. We can also create labels for retention. In the process for creating a retention label, we are going to give the label a name. We're going to add an optional description for admins and something for users. In the real world, we would probably put in something more verbose. Next, we can add tags to describe this label in the file plan. At scale, Microsoft 365 allows us to define hundreds or thousands of policies, which can be applied to millions or billions of documents. Being able to distinguish similar policies can be hard without a file plan to be able to enforce that. We'll take a look at more of the file plan details coming up. Next, we say whether we want this label to be used for retention or not. We can just create a label to be a bit of metadata that we tag a document with, but in most cases, we're building labels to enforce retention rules based on the age of a document or external events. In this case, we can say that the content should be left alone after 7 years, automatically deleted, or trigger a disposition review, allowing us to send a message to someone to review a pool of content when it's approaching its expiration period. In this case, we just want to say that these should be automatically deleted after 5 years. Our timers are based on when the document was created, modified, or classified. We can also optionally associate labels with events. Events are external occasions that are unknown at the time a document is created. For example, the expiration of contracts or an employee leaving the business. We can use labels to define a policy which will remain on hold until a certain period of time after the event is fired. Events can be managed directly inside Microsoft 365 or through our APIs wired up to an external source of record. In this case, we can also say this label should be classified as a record, making the document immutable during the time it is so labeled. An even more powerful capability at scale allows me to automatically apply a label. Automatically applying a label lets me determine conditions. I can build my conditions based on any of the sensitive information types that we ship inside of the service. For instance, if I wanted to look for Australian personally identifiable information, Microsoft already has tests that you can use to automatically tag this document based on those standards. I can also build custom rules based on the full text of a document or on keywords inside of it. We can consume Office 365-based metadata, such as content types or custom columns, by inserting them into the keyword editor. Once I apply these labels, again, I can choose where I want this policy to be applied. And once I designate the specific mailboxes, sites, OneDrives, or group-connected experiences, such as Microsoft Teams, Microsoft 365 will retroactively apply this label to all of the content hosted in Microsoft 365 in a matter of days. Our label analytics engine allows me to see all the labels that exist in my organization for retention and sensitivity and where they've been created. I can drill in and look at specific details to see what's been applied inside SharePoint, OneDrive, Exchange, and double-click for more detail. I can also take advantage of our new file plan capability released in late 2018 to allow me to manage groups of policies at scale. Let's take a look. Here, inside the Compliance Center, I can take a look at my file plan. My file plan shows me all of the content retention policies that have been defined throughout the organization. It allows me to sort and filter based on anything I might want to report against. I can also take action on the file plan by exporting that full list of labels to an Excel CSV format. Here we are inside Excel. We've heard customer feedback that most of our compliance users don't live inside the Compliance Center, but in the common productivity tools we use every day, such as Excel. Our file plan integration allows compliance managers to bring a file plan directly into Excel. From here, they can make a change, such as extending the period of time for a retention policy. And they can make these changes in bulk and save the file plan. Once they've made changes, we can instantly apply their changes through the file plan manager. Once we've edited our downloaded CSV file, it's as simple as importing the new CSV file. When we browse for it, the new file plan will instantly be made available and govern retention and records management for all my content moving forward. We offer a comprehensive solution for retention and records management throughout Microsoft 365.